Hey everybody, thanks so much for tuning in to Showcase. My name is Donn. With me today, once again, is my good friend and colleague, Mr.
Zen. Hello.
All right. And behind the camera is Mr. Staff O'Neill. Good to see you again, Staff. How are you feeling, man?
Hey everybody, pretty good.
Cool. We are about to do a special episode of Controller Freaks, or a special segment of Controller Freaks, where we have the rare opportunity to do something that we've never done on Weekend Showcase before, which is to play a mobile game. Like, we've done a lot of stuff on console, or sometimes on PC. We've been dabbling with that in recent months and years. But we're actually going to swing for the fences here and boot up a mobile game, and not just any mobile game. We're doing Call of Duty. No, not Call of Duty. Not Call of Duty Mobile. Call of Duty Warzone Mobile. It's a completely different kind of experience, basically. You can actually take a look at the menu system for this right now as sort of an indicator for just how much of a console-level mobile experience this is. We're running this on Android, and this is actually a very special COD game because it actually lets you chip away at your battle pass in a way that you don't actually need to be tethered to your console in order to do. So, like, your battle pass XP, your character XP, even your weapon XP carries over to your phone or tablet and then back to your console. So
I didn't know that.
So basically everything that COD Mobile should have been back in 2019,
It is now.
Basically, even though COD Mobile does still exist and it is still an interesting game,
but it's still its own game.
It is very much its own experience. So I mean, take from that what you will, as far as, like, you know, we should have been able to do this back
like
then.
Back then, yeah. And now it's like, oh, now we have a way.
Not complaining. Yeah. I want to be clear. Yeah. Not complaining, Activision, but you know.
Anyway.
But glad to have it now. So let's go ahead and get rolling with this. We're going to do a couple rounds of Mobile Royale. These are the game options here that we have to work with. As you can tell, we have relatively small party sizes and relatively short length playtime as well. You've got an average of 4 people, more or less, per party, and the average game play time lasts about 10 minutes, sometimes as much as 20, sometimes as little as 7. If you take a look at that mosh pit section right there, you have a 6-person party for only 7-minute play time. And you can see on the bottom right corner of the screen there how many players you can expect to show up in the room. Like, for Mobile Royale, what we're about to do is going to be a maximum of 60 players. And when I say players, I mean live players. Like, actual, like, people are doing this on their phones. Like, not, this isn't a bunch of bot lobbies. Let's see. This is a 12-person lobby for Rust. Rebirth Resurgence has 36 players. Battle Royale has 120 players.
Jeez! I never knew it was that many players.
Yeah.
God.
Yeah. So now the question is, and that little fire icon, by the way, on top of Mobile Royale and Plunder on the far left side, those signify, like, the most active at given moment. So given that, Zen, what do you want to see us try first?
Go ahead and jump in some Mobile Royale, dude.
Oh, yeah, and I forgot. We also have, like, individual Mobile Royale. But that's just for, like, you know, if you're just playing by yourself.
Oh, yeah, solos. But, yeah.
So solos or, like, or with two randoms.
What are you feeling? Are you feeling, like, popping in with randoms, or do you want to, like, show these kids what they're missing?
Let's pop in with randoms. Okay. Just for the first one.
All right.
Oh, and by the way, you also have, I forgot to mention, you can also do, like, private lobbies.
Oh, sick. So, like, it's the same as console. So you can do private lobbies on mobile. That's
like
sick.
I said, it's everything that 2019 COD Mobile should have been.
Exactly.
Yes. So, but anyway, enough premise. Let's go ahead and confirm that. Whoops. There he is. And find a match. One other thing I want to bring up is you have, like, special timed events that you can participate in, basically. You know, daily logins. We're familiar with that. And you also have challenges. I've already got a loadout set up to accommodate those first two challenges. 500 damage to opponents with a large machine gun and 2 kills with a shotgun. And the currencies that you get for completing those, you can trade for other things. So that's going to be fun.
And 1 kill with a marksman rifle.
Yeah, well, I don't know how to work with it. I'll be honest, I'm still sort of working on the mechanics of accurately and consistently using the marksman and sniper rifles in this game. I'm really not 100% on that, so I'm not going to presume to, like...
And you know you want to be. Like, you're the sniper in our group, especially on Fortnite.
Yeah, that is true. Here we go. Let's see. Yeah, but here again, like, mobile is a fundamentally... It's a totally different
experience.
It's totally different.
Trust me, I know. I used to play a lot of COD Mobile back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when I was on the move.
Mm. Yeah, it's loading. It's loading in with the other people in the lobby, which, if I remember right, this is one of the 60-player lobbies. So mm-hmm. it's going to be me and two randoms against 57 other people.
Yep. Oh, dude, actually, I mean, besides the rendering, the hands look fairly like...
There
and
it
then
is.
Okay, and then it renders. Sick.
Pretty much. I'm just going to watch this on my phone, and then, like, you guys can watch on the monitor.
Yeah.
For the most part. So this is new. They just put out a new version basically recently where like you can where they put some improvements to the interface.
Mm-hmm.
Hang on, this is a little loud.
That is very loud.
Sorry.
So what they do with the interface?
Is this? Oh, okay. So the thing at the bottom of the screen where it says you are a jump leader. That's me, Cyberlord. you can actually transfer leadership of the party to somebody else in your fire team, just like on
just
console,
like,
basically.
On Apex.
Yep, pretty much. There's our jump trajectory, and there's the cloud circle. Let's go ahead and try the TV station, I guess. Just tap that location on the map and hit this button on the right side to jump out of the helicopter. Here we go. All right. So... one thing that's worth noting regarding the graphics here is, like, things are kind of streaming off of a hotspot Wi-Fi connection right now. This is not, I want to be very clear, this is not off of bars or, like, any sort of, like, 4G, like, fiber optic Wi-Fi or something like that. But even with all of that being said, considering that this game is designed to sort of work off of, to sort of give you streamed graphics.
Right.
And then they gradually improve based on how often you play. Like, this is a really good sort of, like, starting point at the end of the day. You just have to sort of tolerate some crap graphics for your first couple games, more or less. It's, you know, unfortunate but true. Oh, here's one piece of weaponry right there.
Lovely.
There's your self-res kit.
Oh, so you don't start with one, like, on console, though.
You start off with a pistol, and then you sort of, like, find other stuff. Here's an LMG that's useful.
You need that for your, and a sniper.
Battle rifle. That was a battle rifle.
Oh, battle rifle. Might be.
Alright. Now to try to catch up with my teammate, the guy in yellow over there. Alright, here we go. The EP counter at the top of the screen is the special currency. It's not experience points. I forget what it's called precisely, but basically that's the currency that you can generate over the course of your average game to turn in for special little bonus kill streaks and weapons and stuff like that that you can use in like different matches and stuff.
Okay.
So there's a lot to this. My current budget is on the left side of the screen, that 3100 figure, and then like, and you can customize just like on regular COD Mobile, you can customize your interface completely.
Oh man!
So, and remember, it's me and I guess one other fire team member against 58 other people.
Oh, you got a body behind you.
That is true. Where is? Yep, right. There he is.
He's gonna fight your third party and good. He's down.
Yep. Mm-mm.
No, sir.
Dang it.
Oh, yeah. Team wipe. Uh-oh.
Yeah, this isn't gonna be pretty.
Oh, he's right there. I knew it. Oh, he has a DMR, though. He's kind of out back. He's dead.
There we go. Mm-hmm.
Poor guy. Poor soul.
Pretty much.
And I'm pretty sure you just did the... Oh, no. You need a little bit more damage, I think. Hey, friend. And he's dead. Team wipe.
Yep.
Two team wipes and you just started the game.
Yeah, so this is basically sort of a rough sort of understanding of what to expect with this particular version of COD Mobile. Again, I want to stress, like, you know, depending on your graphics, depending on your connection strength, depending on your device and depending on your connection strength, your graphics are going to appear better than this. Uh-oh, there's a vehicle. Okay, you can sort of see on the minimap on the upper right corner of the screen. So, yeah. That can sort of help with the context of how you're operating, generally speaking. Contracts are generally the best way to increase your EP that you come away from any given match with. You can see, like, we started this with, like, 90, and then as I started killing people...
I got a bunch.
So that really sort of stacks up. Oh, I just walked right past another contract. You hear that sound?
Mm-hmm.
You know what that means.
Bounty.
The objective is to eliminate the bounty target.
4,000? Did you just say 4,000 for that bounty?
I missed that part, but... I need to get some more... Shoot, I need to get some more, shields.
But was I don't that have a loadout?
Much time, unfortunately. No, it's not. These are the loadout boxes, but that might be for somebody else.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yep, there's somebody right over here.
Enemy UAV active.
Yep, to your left.
Whoa.
And there's someone behind you? What the heck?
Yep.
Got gas inbound. Safe zone relocated.
Let me try to get ready. And you can, like, crouch down and lie prone as well. Stuff like that.
It really is COD.
Pretty much, pretty much. Yep, there's somebody. There, right over there, right over there.
You got this.
You can also mark people, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Moving.
Surprise.
Oh, he just tried to get a res, and he's dead. Team wipe. Poor guys, poor souls. They had no clue they were being hunted by the Cyber Lord.
And that was actually the bounty target right there.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, look at that EP total at the top of the screen. You can see some progress there.
And you have a bunch of money now. I think this is 18,000?
Yep. 18,000, yeah.
You could get a loadout, honestly.
Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and get my normal loadout, actually, if I can clear that 260 meters or so.
Yep.
I'm also playing this muted as far as microphones. So unfortunately, the random teammate that I have in here in this room with me, I see two moving specks over there. He cannot hear anything that we're saying, unfortunately. But you can actually engage in group chat with the lobby or with your teammates if that's how you prefer to play.
Your seventh kill.
I don't know that for sure yet. So
yeah, you do. He's right there. You got this. You're a legend.
Yep, right there.
Yeah, he has no clue you're here.
I bet he does.
No, he's clueless. He's in the middle of a fight.
Yep, I'm getting overwhelmed.
No, you're not. You got this.
That was close. I was a little nervous there, not gonna lie.
Team wipe. Oh, they weren't even on teams?
That's probably the only reason why I was able to survive that, basically. Oh,
there's
shoot.
His teammate.
They'll fight for a chance to redeploy.
That's not good. Oh, no.
I don't
know
where that was. I couldn't tell where that came from.
It was from both directions, from behind you and in front of you.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, you have a self-revive.
It's not going to work.
Oh. That guy's invisible? Oh, there's a dude right next to you.
I'm trying to be careful here. This guy.
Team wipe. Oh, he's trying to run you over.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
Aw, you have
I'm proud
that.
Of that. I'm
you
proud
are,
of
you
that.
You should
I'm not
be.
Even...
9 kills?
Yeah. And I think the vehicle might get me. Nope, somebody else's, I think. Yeah, I'm done. I was low-key expecting
wait,
that.
Wait, you still have the gulag.
That's... I think so.
Yeah, you still have the gulag. You haven't died yet.
Well, I've died, but it's like...
Well, now. Oh, I mean, yeah, like, you've just died.
I lasted too long. I think I lasted too long. The option is over.
Yeah, the gulag's over now.
I'm proud of that, though. 9 kills on the first one? All right. Oh, sorry, 9 unalives, I guess.
Yeah, unalives.
For the internet. Fine, whatever. Staff, what are your thoughts so far on COD Warzone Mobile?
He looks mesmerized.
I've never seen anything like this before. I didn't even know you could put something this big on a phone.
I know, right?
Pretty much. The footprint, depending on your device, the overall footprint is going to be different sizes, basically. Also, depending on how much like patch data and stuff. I almost said Amazon. Oh my God.
Activision
rolls out, or whatever like company they've subcontracted out the mobile support to. The version that we're seeing right now has a footprint of about 10 gigs or so.
There's three people left, not counting your teammate. Maybe he can clutch this.
Yeah, let's be careful there. That red area. All know what happens.
That's the
here.
Gas.
This is straight up battle royale. There's just no other way to describe it, basically, at this point. I can also press this button on those two buttons on the right side. I can press the left one to request my teammate to redeploy me. So that's a thing.
And he has money too. It's not like he.
He does. I can also show what his loadout is. This is what he's using right now.
Oh, the M4.
So I guess we can sort of bear that in mind with regard to player expectations. Here's the overall view of the map, or what's left of the map. Good lord.
Yeah, I don't think he can redeploy you either. There's no buy stations.
Yeah. Never mind that. This last wave of the map is going to sort of expire at about 30 seconds. That's going to be circle 5, I think.
Oh, can you pull this off? I know you just saw those guys, dude.
I did all of the heavy work. Yep, there's one.
You really did? He's blind.
Or depending on what his device is like, because don't
forget, probably rendered
thing.
In. Yeah.
There's another thing. I'm not sure if I mentioned. It gives you a certain level of graphical fidelity, and it improves based on how much you're able to play. So it streams in higher quality graphics, and your device retains the higher quality graphics more and more as you play.
Oh, I guess that makes sense. Like for people who are just now starting, and so they can't just hop on and just
whoa.
Come on, mate. You got this.
Come on.
Oh, he's not even looking at you anymore. Shoot him.
Whoa.
What? First game on.
And that is how you do COD on mobile, ladies and gentlemen.
You did all the heavy lifting. Let's be real.
Now, hang on. I think this is going to go to me.
Oh, it has to.
Hang on. Yeah, these are all the gamer tags of all the other players that we sort of...
You're going to be first.
I think that's me on the blue. No, that's
your teammate. Yeah, you went up first because you're first place.
And I realized I had the ghillie suit. So mm-hmm. Yeah, yep, there it is. There's me.
You're first place. Yep.
Everybody.
You carried that man. Dude, you carried that dude to a win, and he just somehow clutched the end.
So, and then it gives you the after action report for everything that was done. We got one challenge done. There we go. Two contracts done, 2,900 damage, 9 kills, 5,200 points. And a partridge in a pear tree.
You were first place. Oh, man.
So there you go. There's game number one. And that took about 18 minutes, roughly. A little less than that, actually. We had to sort of set the table for it a little bit. So maybe about 10, 15 minutes or something. Yeah. And now it prompts you for the little thing.
Yeah, there. You gotta rate the game.
Come on, man. What are you doing? But anyway, so yeah, that's the... Oh, wait, and let's take a look at over here. Need a marksman rifle. Just whatever. We'll see if I can get to that. I also want to bring up, you can also use your console's double XP tokens.
Oh, what?
Check that out.
Oh, wow.
All of your battle pass... Oh, shoot. We loaded in the next one. It's fast loading into the next games. But you can tell where I was going next with that. You can actually generate even if you have one of those Mountain Dew or Jack Link's jerky double XPs on console, that gets tied to your Activision account, and that's what you load into this mobile game with. Huh. So while you still have to go through the normal methods to redeem those codes and stuff like that, it's completely up to you if you want to actually go through generating double XP in console or in mobile.
Oh, that's nice that they give you the choice too.
And this game has only been out for 2 weeks or so, maybe 3, I think, by now, at the time that we're recording this. So it's holy crap.
your hands look better.
Yeah, see what I mean? It's sort of it's done a lot of the streaming already, so now it sort of plays a little bit cleaner. A little bit. Obviously, the shading is a little bit. Yeah.
The keyword.
And, yep, here we go. Oh, yeah, that was the last few seconds.
Mm-hmm. Last few seconds, you can't hit anybody.
Whatever. Anyway, whatever, it's fine.
They took that out. You used to be able to execute people, and, at the end, and then they took that out. They, patched it at the same time on Warzone 2.
Yeah.
And they used to, when you did an execution, it would, what's it called? It would make you invincible. And they took that out, too. But, like, it makes sense. Like, if you're already in the middle of an execution, should, and, like...
Hang on one second. When you're not the leader, I want to point this out. When you're not the leader, it seems to give you the option to sort of, like, automatically follow whoever's the leader of your party. So, like, there it is. So, like, your parachute deploys at the same time as theirs, you know, you're automatically sort of, like, following the landing trajectory of your fire team leader. You can't really tell with this camera angle, I know, but, yeah, whatever. There it is. You're still in third-person view for the most part, until you land right there. And it gives you that same pistol by default.
He's cracked, and he's down.
Yep. Reload. Oh, shoot. This one's gonna send me to the gulag, I know. Yeah, that one messed up. Hell yeah, you can also use executions.
Oh, wow.
There's a fight kicking off.
So yeah, all the executions that you can use on, well, not all, I want to say.
Most.
There are a lot of executions that you have on console that you can bring over here. There are a lot of character skins on console. Look at this.
Yeah,
this
is the console. Gulag. This is console, it is. It's literally the scene from console.
Mm-hmm.
You in the gulag.
When they say Warzone Mobile, they mean Warzone Mobile. So glad that I got to win that first match.
Yeah.
So yeah, this is what the gulag looks like in Warzone Mobile.
Now you have nothing to prove, because you've already proved yourself.
Wow, somebody was straight gunned down right there. Okay, here we go. Okay, so I gotta take care of this guy over here before he can take me out completely. I don't know where he's gonna come from exactly. I'm making a mistake already, I know.
He's probably gonna go for a flag. Yep. He's just looking in
really?
A corner. What the heck?
Yeah, I think he had an issue.
Yeah, a disconnection problem. Poor guy.
Maybe. That's the thing you have to sort of bear in mind with mobile games at all times anyway. Like, there's a chance, like, if you're dealing with a real person on the other end, there could be technical difficulties in the device or with the network connection. You know, it can happen.
Ooh.
Unfortunate, but it does. All right, let's try for...
I was gonna say, you probably land on loadout.
Yep. I'm gonna try.
Being the keyword.
Yeah. I see one of my teammates is already out, it looks like. That yellow guy. I'm gonna try to get this loadout over here from the blue crate, then hike over here. Looks like to the west. We'll see if that works out.
Your teammate was sent to the gulag. They'll fight for
poor guy.
You can actually, like, ditch your thing a little bit early, and then it'll automatically deploy. Your thing, I mean the parachute.
Parachute.
And then it'll automatically deploy one more time. So grab that, and grab your loadout of choice. Which also comes with perks. You can customize your perks beforehand. Shoot.
Oh, they're coming to loadout.
Yep. I'm gonna ditch this. Know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em.
Know when to friendly.
Please don't ban me for content ID violation, YouTube, by me singing this song. All right. Yeah, I gotta find a way over to number two. This is wide open space. There's no cover. No choice.
Just run. Run away.
Run, Forrest, run! Trying to keep my head on a swivel here. No idea, like, where...
Mm-hmm.
People are kind
of
coming from.
Oh, and they're still there, of course. Just screw it. Just run away. Yeah. Just run away. Don't look back. It's the last thing you want to do is look back. Oh, your boy just timed out.
Oh, yep, there's him. That's the guy that was hunting me down right then.
He does not seem to like you very much.
Nope.
I have not a clue why, but...
I'm gonna see if I can do this. Because he's coming right up behind me one way or another.
Yep. He has no clue. He was clueless. Oh, finish him with the shotgun. For the challenge.
It's not letting me. Alright, there it is.
Oh, what the? Why was it wasn't letting you shoot?
So the way that I have, that kind of backfired on me. That was weird. So the way that I have my thing set up, I was hoping it would do that way sooner. The way that I have my thing set up is if you're within melee range with any weapon.
Oh, wow, and melees instead of...
Yeah, because I was wondering, shoot, that's right, I forgot I turned off the melee button. You can actually disable or enable all the buttons on the interface, basically, on the touch interface.
Right.
So yeah, that's an instance where that kind of backfires, because I was hoping the auto melee would sort of kick in there so that it would play the execution animation, but whatever, it's fine.
It didn't. It was like meleeing and...
Quest, redeploy, there it is. He's got the money, he can spare it. And it looks like, let me see, does he have another...
He's running straight into a fight.
Yeah, that's gonna be messy.
He's missing most of his shots. My dude, if you're gonna shoot,
Under normal circumstances, this is when I would try to snipe, but...
Oh, yeah, he's dead.
He doesn't even have that. He didn't even
he's
have a
dead.
Sniper. Yeah. Yeah, that's that. Did I mention how glad I am that I managed to get almost 10 kills?
I think so.
On that first match? Like, I'm going to be doing a little end zone dance in my head about that the whole rest of the stream, not going to lie. Yeah, it's a regular theme sequence from NCIS, basically. That's exactly what's going in my head right now. And I guess now we have a perspective on his gulag experience.
Hopefully he's just as lucky.
Wow.
He is just as lucky. I don't know what that guy was doing. It looked like he was either timed out or about to time out.
I have no idea. But anyway, he's back in the match here. And his loadout is the Rival 9, it looks like.
Yep.
And Signal 50 for the secondary. That's what he's sort of like rolling in with. Semtex and TAC grenades. Let's see.
Flash, to be precise.
And now he's within the inner edge of the next circle, so he's safe from the next storm cycle, but I saw a few red blips pop up on that mini-map. Oh yeah, you have kill streaks also. Some people can actually, like, use,
like the UAVs and the counter UAVs. What's the other one?
Dive bomber.
The SAEs.
Support helos.
Yeah.
Attack helos.
Attack helo. Here we go.
Whoa! That's a whole team.
Oh, yeah, and he just downed one. And they're
not
in the middle
time,
of a fight.
Not enough time. He doesn't have enough time to clean that up from a distance without completely giving away his position.
He has no idea
what the other side is. I think he's getting flanked. Yeah, he's definitely
getting flanked. Unless...
Not downstairs. I would jump out the window.
Honestly,
here.
What are you doing? Don't watch the stairs, guy.
Or at least not when you're fully standing up.
Right,
you gotta decrease your center of mass.
Yeah, like, don't just be sitting there. Yeah. Or
again,
mount.
we're watching the team. We're watching the spectator cam for my teammate here. I've already, you know, done the gulag before and been eliminated from that. So, this person, my teammate right in here. This is a random person. I don't know this Double G Kev guy. Whoa!
Double G Kev timed out.
I mean, revive it. Sorry, revive X. Ah, shoot. Eighth place. All right. Well, it happens.
Yeah, well, you had a really good game the first game, let's be honest.
Yeah, let's start. Let's keep talking about the first game.
That first game was, like, the best game I've seen.
It's still got the challenge in progress there, and those are the things there. And I love how it goes through, on the after-action report, it actually goes through and breaks down everything that you were able to do over the course of the game on every metric that you were making progress on,
like
even
damage,
the challenges.
Yeah.
Even the challenges, it just says in progress, but it's sort of like that little subconscious reminder that it's still doing that running count, that's still keeping track of everything that you're doing, regardless of how successful or not you were with making forward progress here. So, how much... Okay, so let's see. We have, looks like we have a little bit of time left here. Do we want to try this out? Do we want to try this out?
Me? You know... Sure.
Now that I've fully set the bar for you.
Sure.
Done all of the hard work. All right. How do we do this? Very, very carefully here. There's kind of a short in the HDMI export wire here, but... I'm hoping this will...
It's scary.
That
is scary. I don't...
Hang on.
Oh, that's the time.
It's fine. There we go. Okay.
Okay.
So that's that. So if you pick up a sniper rifle, the bottom set of triggers basically correspond to what L3 and R3 would be.
Okay.
So, like, the bottom left trigger would be, like, you know, hold your breath. You know, that sort of thing.
Okay.
Don't purchase COD points. Don't purchase COD points.
Whoa.
Stay out of my credit card. What are you doing?
What are you doing, game?
Yeah. All right. So we're going to give Zen the wheel for this last match. We'll see how he does, and then we'll point our fingers and joke derisively. Once this is done, we'll go ahead and shut down the stream from there. So I want to make sure he has a chance to go ahead and try this out, and we'll be able to give a more accurate sort of review of what this game is capable of on most cylinders.
Right.
It's still killing me that we don't have better Wi-Fi connection to be able to do this with, but it's better than nothing, and considering what this game is capable of on this kind of connection that we have here, gives you an idea of what, like, maximum, like, the top tier,
like output,
an S24,
yeah,
kind of like current, current Android would do on, like, fiber, you know, or whatever your home Wi-Fi kind of is, basically. Like, do you even need a console at that point?
Dude, you know? No, honestly, I don't think so, especially with, like, the grip controller. This, like... It feels like it's comfortable.
That's why we have it. but yeah, you're going to need to really resist the urge to look up at that monitor, though, because that's going to be really visually disorienting. You have to be glued.
Because, like, you can't... you got to know where everything is. This is where all the buttons are.
I'm going to, like, adjust this monitor a little bit.
Is there, like, a circle?
It'll show up.
No, I'm saying there's like an actual circle on your like screen. I don't know what the heck that is.
There we go. So you can tap the unfollow button to reject the idea to have the game like automatically sort of like make you jump out when the party leader jumps and like all that sort of thing.
Okay.
Otherwise, you can just leave it on and it'll autopilot you out into the ground. This really is freaking amazing. Like, this, can we just stop and for a moment and like appreciate the fact that we live in the year 2024?
And we can play Call of Duty on a mobile.
This is bananas. This is bananas. There's just no other way to sort of put it. Okay. So I think we're still. Wait. You said you will jump by yourself. So you rejected the follow. Okay. So you're gonna have to keep track. Yep. There they go. You gotta jump now.
Did they already? Okay. They did.
Yeah, you gotta manually follow them down to the ground here.
Which is okay. I do it on a daily anyway.
Mm-hmm. If you miss the cue to, like, do that last, that last parachute thing, like, the game does that for you. Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Careful. Okay. Please don't unalive yourself on the way in. Good grief. Yeah, you gotta find some ammunition and another weapon now. You can drive vehicles, by the way, also. I forgot to mention that.
Like in regular Warzone.
Yep.
Oh, I thought that was breakable.
Not all... Like, you ran through a friendly claymore, yeah.
Yeah,
that
was quite friendly. That's the only reason I ran through.
Yeah. Next building. Whoa! Come on!
Dude!
There it is. Teammate got that.
I'm pressing it. It's not going.
Get close. All right, never mind. All right, there you go. Yeah, try not to. Oh shoot! No. Go into the next building.
Okay. Well.
You need a stronger weapon, not the sniper rifle.
That's not a good weapon. Sir, would you mind not messing with me? I feel like we could be really good friends.
You still need another weapon.
I am looking, I'm trying to find one. Oh my gosh, this is not a weapon.
Oh, there. Yep.
Pick it up.
It's not great, but it'll have to do. Cluster mines, you just picked that up.
I'm trying to pick up the suppression mine. What the heck?
You already picked it up. Okay. You already picked it up. That's that other button. Yeah. The other button underneath the mini map.
Okay. Oh, what the heck?
Cancel that. There you go. You have a ladder there. You can climb up to the top there.
My big fingers are not helping.
At this point, you should be okay. You just need to get another. You just need to get that backlog of get some more armor plates. I would honestly head in the opposite direction to get to the buy station, and use some of that money to get some more armor plates.
Okay.
Wrong way.
I have to go with my team.
You gotta hit to the... Yeah, see, now you have, now it's at discount, so you have to go back to the yellow...
You mean the buy station.
Yeah, the buy station, that's what I'm saying.
I didn't realize I had money.
You gotta get in there and be very careful with it.
What am I trying to
nearby.
Get?
Goodbye station. Oh, shoot.
Wait, where?
I don't know.
There are people.
There's no red dots. Oh. There you go.
What the heck?
Self-res.
Well, I'm not gonna be able to, yeah. It's alright.
Alright, it's okay.
It's my first time. I don't play COD Mobile.
I was hoping they'd be more gentle with you, considering it was your first time. But,
Really?
No, they weren't.
Yes, Staff, yes. Every chance I get to make a joke like that, yes. Have you not been paying attention? We do cheesy dad joke kind of humor. Alright.
Do you not know who Donn Cheadle is?
Alright, here we go.
Oh my gosh, I'm lagging.
Whoa!
Oh, he just almost blew me up.
Okay, yeah, he's gonna be right there. Amazingly, that worked out.
okay. I didn't know I didn't have to press the aim down sights for it to aim down sights.
Well, yeah. There's your loadout drop. So I have two sets of loadouts already sort of configured. You can sort of work out with that, and either one of those will give you a set of perks.
Okay.
I would go with that first one.
The first one?
Yeah. Okay.
Well, where is my...
There's your boxes. You're running past boxes.
Am I?
Yep. With the outline around it. To left, huh? Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time.
Oh, there it is. Oh my gosh, I'm blind.
Okay, there's your self-res. To the left.
To the left? Where?
Look to the left. Everything you need to pick up is in the box to the left.
I'm looking left. This is left.
Straight up, straight ahead. Okay, see that green?
Oh, that's the buy station.
Wait, look up.
I don't need the buy station right now, though.
Oh, okay, never mind, you're fine.
Unless my teammate... Is my teammate still here?
Yeah, that's the one on the minimap. The green one.
Then I guess... Hold on. Oh, he's in the gulag, that's why. Mm-hmm. He's finishing his gulag.
Wait, go back to the buy station one last time.
What's up? Wait, wasn't I just... Where the heck?
Right there.
Mm-mm. It's on the other side. What the...
Nope.
Dude!
I don't know, where in the heck... Go. Look up.
I am looking up.
Look around.
To be here. I just...
Maybe it disappeared after an activity.
You know what? I'm walking away.
Okay, the idea was to use $900 to purchase a collection of, to fill up your reserve of...
the armor plates, but I'll find some eventually.
Yeah.
Or I'll try to.
Just keep your head on a swivel and try to stay near 1 and 2 on the minimap.
He's just laying down.
He's trying to camp his way through this.
Well, I don't camp.
Well.
I'm not a camper. I hear a,
Yeah, that's your... Yeah, you can hear your teammate's footsteps.
No, the box. But,
oh.
I hear an armor box. Or not an armor box, but a... A supply box. Is it upstairs?
Maybe upstairs.
How would I go about... Oh, here.
I would try not to go around like that. Like, you're very exposed tactically.
I'm trying to get above.
This doesn't work precisely like the console game in terms of navigationally. Like, you really have to be, like, within arm's reach.
Well, that makes me sad.
I know. That's one of a few sort of, like, trade-offs about this game, unfortunately, but,
yeah. That's a little sad, but it's okay. I'll live. If I can, as long as I can do this.
Whoa, to the left. There.
Oh, that's a tap fire. Why is it a tap fire?
It shouldn't be.
It is.
Oh, hit the thing that says single at the top of the screen?
Wait.
At the top of the weapon.
At the top of the weapon?
Yeah. You see where it says the word single? Underneath armor plate?
What?
Underneath the button that says armor plate combat defense, underneath that there's a really tiny single.
Oh, I see it. I'm blind, that's why.
There it is. Okay, that's full auto.
I was like, why is it on semi-automatic?
Yeah, I don't have an answer for that one. but okay. Shh, be very, very quiet. Zen's hunting rabbits.
There's a dude down there. How do I mark?
That little, like, yeah. Yeah, you have to be really sort of precise with your aiming there. There it is. He might be kind of screwed because he's like outside of the field of. You know. Oh, hello. Bam. Did you, ooh.
I hear someone.
Reload your weapon. Alright, that didn't do very much, but yeah, always make sure.
I only reload when I really, really need to. Most times. Oh. I know there has to be people nearby.
Right there! Get him! Wow, that was close.
Oh no, teammate.
Yeah, there's no time.
Yeah, teammate, you might be. Oh!
No, don't run in there.
I'm trying to put on plates and run away.
Circle around to the left. Nope. Okay. Oh, yep. I knew it was from the left. I knew it'd be from the left.
Self-res. I knew it too, but oh my god, just use the self-res.
Almost made that. He slid to home plate on that. Just put it down. It's fine.
Well, right, I liked it. It's kind of weird because I feel like I probably would have done better with just mobile. I've never used the grip controller before, but it is nice. I'm not going to say it's not nice. It is really nice.
Fair enough. All right.
There we go.
All right, so I guess that's basically that. Yeah, you got a couple kills, 760 damage, no contact.
I got two kills.
I mean, you could have had none. That's what that is. Yeah. All right, I guess final verdict on Warzone Mobile.
I like it. I think it's a good spin on like what they should have done, like you said in the beginning.
Oh, hang on, sorry.
Yeah, mute that. Like you said in the beginning, I feel like they should have had this set up or at least had it in the works a long time ago. But, I mean, it's for what it is and for what, like, them bringing it out, like, now. I mean, it's good. I mean, I wish they would have brought it out back then, but it's...
Mm-hmm. I hear you. This thing is... Yeah, we don't need to glorify that guy, whoever the winner teams are. Yeah.
Forget that guy. Fine.
Come on, skip that. Staff, your thoughts?
Main menu.
Like I said, I think it's pretty amazing they're able to fit something like this on a phone.
Do y'all have a favorite operator or a favorite weapon? Wait a minute, Staff, do you even play COD?
Not at all.
I have a favorite operator, Grumsky.
Okay.
He has a, his execution is called Bong Rip. And he like,
what?
Yeah, so he like smashes a bong and like he'll pick you up, like the normal version of it, he picks you up and like choke slams you on top of like the broken glass.
How do you swirly somebody with like a broken bong?
No, he picks them up like choke slam.
Like
oh, you mean like, oh yeah, rock yeah, like yeah, rock yeah, bottom. Yeah. Like then yeah. He'll rock bottom you into like onto yeah. like the broken glass.
I'm imagining like, you know, instead of a toilet, like literally yeah. just, yeah, wow.
And,
wow.
like, basically you get choke slammed into a cloud of smoke, so hence bong. Rip.
Wow. Yeah. Okay, wow. But dude.
Yeah, I know, right? It's kind of brutal. And then there's, like, my other favorite execution is called bend and snap.
Okay.
And my favorite version, like, variant of that is when you down someone, because, like, he slaps them in the back of the head and then, like, proceeds to roll them over and then snaps their neck. Like, oh, my God.
Wow.
Yeah.
Staff, are we still recording on your end?
Yes, yeah, recording.
Okay. Okay. So, Steph, I know you don't actually play COD, but I mean, I don't know. What, dude, could you see yourself like as being like pretty much an outsider to this? Like, do you see this as like an understandable and appealable sort of like entry point if you had it in you to try COD?
Yeah, I see the appeal for it, especially in the multiplayer. Mm-hmm. Like, that's the main thing. It seems like it's mostly multiplayer focused and it seems like a good time. Like, you got a bunch of your friends over, or even if they're not over, like,
just game anytime. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like, get a group of friends going.
I also forgot to mention, they still don't have a zombies mode in here. Warzone Mobile does not have a zombies mode, but regular COD Mobile does have a zombies mode still. Yeah. Like, they've had that for years. But Warzone is Warzone.
Everybody's wanting them to go back to, like, Black Ops 3, Black Ops 2 zombies. Like, I don't know. I myself, I don't mind, like, the Cold War zombies, and but, like, a lot of people don't like the like, health bar over their head, and, yeah.
Yeah. Is that where you stand?
I mean, where I stand is zombies. I like zombies, and I'm going to play it, even if it's not what it used to be. I like the spin on it. Like, I like the new, like, ether stuff, and, like, having, like, the abilities, like, the auras in order, like, the healing aura, and then, like, the freezing, like, the cryo-freeze aura and all that. Like, I'm down with it.
Cool, cool.
Yeah.
But don't forget, you need a little revive.
Oh, that's what I miss. That's the only thing I miss. Was the Perca-Colas.
Yeah.
Perca-Colas was the best iteration in any.
Agreed. I agree with that.
Juggernog, Widow's Peak.
And now we're finally at the part of the show where we get to share the dad joke of the day. Zen, what is today's dad joke of the day?
All right. Today's dad joke is, I used to be addicted to soap, but I'm clean now.
Okay.
And if that one didn't hit, we all...
I mean, it's witty. It's witty. It's a witty? Good, it's a good play on the wordplay a little bit. What's you have another one?
Oh, I only wanted to do this one because I liked how it sounded.
Okay.
A guy walks into a bar, and he was disqualified from the limbo contest.
Oh yeah, that's just a cardinal sin right there. Yeah. You can't just walk into a limbo contest. Like there are rules for this sort of thing. You know? That should be a given. Anyway, whatever. All right, so that's it for this episode of Showcase. Thanks so much for tuning in to Weekend Showcase. My name is Don. With me today was
Zen Morningstar.
And
Stavonil.
Yeah. And once again, special thanks to our good friends at SKST Studios in Virginia Beach, Virginia for the wonderful studio headquarters. And don't forget to hit us up online at your social media platform of choice at Weekend Showcase or on our website, linktr.ee/weekendshowcase, and hit us up in the contact form on there for, like, if you want to refer to us, any games you want to see us play, or if you have any dad jokes to suggest, that's how you get them to us. So yeah, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.